Hi, good morning. So to continue with the saga of real vector spaces, so last time we talked about finding a basis given a spanning set, right? And we said we can do it nicely for a subset of R upper n or R sub n, right? Because we set up those the matrix and we look for the leading ones and so on and so forth. You can refer to what I'm talking about for my students. That was section 4.6, okay? In our book, okay? So that works nicely for n vectors, okay? N by one or one by n vectors. But then you ask, well, what about the matrices? What about the polynomials? How do we do it for those, okay? And the key to that is really appealing to what we call coordinates, okay? And establishing an isomorphism, and that's going to be the topic of our section 4.8, okay? So let's see what these two mean, okay? Okay, so let me first explain coordinates, or actually we're going to talk about the coordinate vector, okay? For this, we're going to talk of, let's say, a basis S consisting of vectors V1, V2, Vn, okay? And if we have another basis T, let's say consisting of V2, V1, so notice I just interchanged the order, okay, of V1 and V2, we call these two ordered basis, okay? I guess the plural of basis is basis, okay? So, but anyway, each one is an ordered basis. Okay, now I wasn't so sure of that. All right, so this is an ordered basis. This is another ordered basis. So the order matters, okay? So for example, if you have P sub 2, okay? If you talk of the natural basis T squared, T and 1, all right? That's an ordered basis. But if I, let's say, write this as 1, T squared, and T, this is a different ordered basis, okay? So what happens is we're going to define what we mean by the coordinate vector of a vector V, okay, in the vector space V, all right? So if we have, if let's say this is an ordered basis for V, then we know that any vector in V can be written as a linear combination of these, right? Okay, so let's say we have a1 v1 plus a2 v2 plus and so on plus a sub n v sub n, all right? The definition of coordinate vector is that, and we denote it by this symbol, coordinate vector of V with respect to S is nothing but the n by 1 vector a1, a2, down to a sub n. So notice this is an element of R upper n. Okay, so that's the coordinate vector of V with respect to the ordered basis S. Okay, on the other hand, if we, since let's say T is also an ordered basis with respect of the vector space V, okay, we can write this, let's say, as B1 V2 plus B2 V1. And so on and so forth, right? Let's say I just switched the first two, okay? B sub n, V sub n. And likewise, the coordinate vector of V with respect to T is the n by 1 vector B1, V2, Vn. Okay, I hope that's clear. All right, so, okay, so for instance, if I have, let's say in P2, I have the polynomial, let's say 3t squared minus 4t plus 5. Okay, and let's say I consider my natural basis t squared, t and 1, okay? Now, this is the natural basis, so it's very easy to see what the coordinate vector of this is, right? So let's call this p of t. Then we say the coordinate vector of p of t with respect to s is nothing but 3, negative 4, 5, okay? On the other hand, if I consider the other ordered basis, let's say t squared 1, for instance, I like it in that order, then the coordinate vector of p of t with respect to t is now going to look like what? First you write negative 4, then 3, then 5, okay? So notice the coordinate vector of p of t, which is in p sub 2, okay, is an element of R3, R upper 3. Likewise, if you have another ordered basis, you have an element of R upper 3, okay? All right, so if we look at exercise number 4 from our book, vector space is again P sub 2, all right? And let's say our ordered basis S consists of these three polynomials, t squared minus t plus 1, t plus 1, and t squared plus 1. Our task is to find the coordinate vector. So this is what we're given. We're asked to find the coordinate vector of V with respect to S. And now we don't have a natural basis, so it's harder to see, all right? So really, all we want to do is what? If we want to find the coordinate vector of this with respect to S, the solution really is simply to express 4t squared minus 2t plus 3 as a linear combination of these three, right? So let's say we have a sub 1, t squared minus t plus 1, plus a sub 2 times t plus 1, the quantity, plus a sub 3 times the quantity t squared plus 1, okay? And again, if you equate coefficients of like powers of t, then you'll end up with a system involving what? You first equate the coefficients of t squared, so that's one equation, right? Equate the coefficients of t, that's the second equation. Equate the constant term with the constants on the right, so that's your third equation. So you come up with a 3x3 system, right? Okay, which we can set up as follows, okay? So you can verify that this is what you'll get in matrix, in augmented matrix form. That's 1, negative 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1. And then on the right side, you'll have 4, negative 2, 3. Let's see if we can figure this out, how I did this. So let's see, on the left side, you have 4. I put that left side on the right. That's 4, okay? Coefficient of t squared is 1a1. So this column is really for the a1 unknown, right? Okay, 1a1. There's no a2 t squared, and then there's a 1a3 t squared, okay? Did I do that right? Okay, so yeah, this is this first one. So 1, 0, 1, 4, okay. So that's what's happening. And then here you'll have negative 2 is here, right? And then this is the negative 1a1t plus a2t, right? Okay, and then there's no t here. Okay, so I guess you got that, right? So again, all we have to do is pivot. In my class, we pivot, do it a bunch of times until you end up with, in this case, I ended up with the identity matrix and I got 1, negative 1, 3. So therefore, that tells me that, I hope you see this, the coordinate vector of V with respect to S is 1, negative 1, 3. So it's, again, solving a system of linear equations. That's mainly what linear algebra is all about, okay?